Members of the Class of 2020, family and friends, welcome, and thank you for joining us to celebrate this extraordinary class at this extraordinary moment in time. This is certainly not how any of us imagined your commencement day. As promised, we'll rightly celebrate you today in this tribute, and when it is safe to do so, we'll invite everyone to return to Cooper Square for our traditional ceremony in our storied Great Hall. I can't wait to see each of you there. So many moments have been taken from you this spring, and yet this is your moment in so many ways, on so many levels. This is your moment to celebrate. This is your moment to be proud. This is your moment to commence the next chapter of your lives. You are prepared and ready, and the world needs you more than ever. With your ingenuity and resilience, your resolve and heart, you will be the ones to find solutions and breakthroughs, to expose our ills and forge our paths to a better place, to create joy and discover beauty. You will help to define our next steps as a society, to illuminate and shape the way forward. As graduates of the Cooper Union, you are keenly equipped for this. You are part of a lineage that has made transformative contributions to society for more than 160 years. At the very beginning of that lineage stands Peter Cooper, of course. As our founder and benefactor, he set out, in his words, quote, "to make this institution contribute in every way possible, to unite all in one common effort to improve each and every human being, seeing that we are bound up in one common destiny." What do these words mean in life amidst a global pandemic? A common effort, a common destiny, the desire to improve each and every human life. But how can we get there in the face of so much challenge? Through your disciplines. Through your art, you expose what we can't see, to reflect on what's there, to imagine what could be. As artists, you challenge us to think differently, to reflect on our own humanity and our place in the world. As architects, you do this too. You push the boundaries of how we engage in the physical realm. You create spaces of gathering, spaces to work and play, spaces to think and create. As engineers, you help to define the way our communities work, the way our infrastructure supports us. You can design our path forward toward ethical technological advances, toward medical and other scientific breakthroughs that benefit all. Individually and together, across disciplines, you will guide us toward a better shared life and toward greater resiliency. If there is one thing this graduating class is, it's resilient. You have a way of pushing your work forward even in the face of adversity. Perhaps your practice even helps us process that adversity. Many of us started our time at Cooper together. I joined many of you midway through your first year, as together we worked to take new steps forward in the face of tremendous challenge. We've seen a lot together. The inauguration and impeachment of a new US president, Brexit, the Me Too movement, Wonder Woman and Black Panther adding new energy to our cinematic universe. A super blue blood moon for the first time in a century and a half. And NASA's first mission to the sun and its outermost atmosphere, called the Corona. And this year, a global pandemic. We have experienced and moved through many ups and downs. Through joy and tragedy, you have been relentless in your pursuit of new thinking, making, creating. You have persevered, and it shows. For those going directly into the work world, your list of employers reads like a who's who on the world's leading list of companies, research institutions, and organizations, where you will work to transform the way we do things. Others are heading to graduate school and can look forward to conducting important research and study, or deepening your practice at leading programs and top-tier universities. Some of you will delve immediately into building your own professional practice. For others, still, plans may have had to change. and perhaps you are taking this opportunity to regroup, to develop your practice, to care for yourself or your loved ones, to reflect on the significance of our present moment and what it means for your individual work and the world's collective work ahead. To these students, I say, your life and your career are a marathon, with these months only the first quarter mile. There will be plenty of time for you to make your stamp, and there's no need to rush ahead. You have been mentored and guided by a faculty of nationally and internationally renowned experts who have cared deeply about your success here at Cooper, from before you arrived as they were reviewing your applications to the very end as they pivoted quickly with you this spring. I know they, as I, will follow your paths and your progress intently as you pursue your passions in the years ahead. By virtue of your membership in the class of 2020, you are also a permanent member of the Cooper Union family. In fact, you will actually hear from some of that extended Cooper family today. And to all of the family and friends watching from afar today, this is your moment too. You have supported and encouraged your students' journeys. You were some of their earliest teachers. Thank you to each and every one of you. This is your day too. Graduates, on behalf of our entire Cooper community, I commend you. You inspire me. You give me hope for our future. With your grace and courage, with your talent and work ethic, you are ready to contribute to a world that needs you. Congratulations, Cooper Union Class of 2020, and thank you. Take care of yourselves and those around you. Stay connected to Cooper, and until we meet again in the Great Hall for your formal commencement, be well. This is your moment.
Good morning to the Class of 2020 and all of those who are gathered around you today to celebrate your day. On behalf of the Board of Trustees, many of whom, like you, were students at this fine institution, I offer you our hearty congratulations. And although I was never technically a student, I think I've received many of the same benefits of being at Cooper Union as you have. I have been taught some very valuable lessons by an incredibly talented, caring, and professional faculty. I have learned the value of commitment and hard work from everyone on the staff and in the administration, as they are ably led by President Sparks, where they have done so much and done so much more every time we have asked it of them. It's truly impressive. But most important to me, I have been schooled by you, the best and brightest students at any school, anywhere. You inspire us every day with your intellectual curiosity, your desire, and your dedication. Whenever I am worried about the current state of affairs, and I worry about that quite often nowadays, I am comforted by the fact that your generation will lead us forward. Some of you may know my story. I came to be involved in Cooper Union through my father, Bill Warren, an alumnus of the school who graduated in 1950. My dad loved the school, and once I got involved, I understood why. He was so excited to be celebrating this year his 70th reunion. That was to happen in June, but like you guys, he's gonna have to do it online over Zoom, but he'll be there, just like you are. But most of all, my greatest hope and wish for you is that in the year 2090, when, like my father, you return to Cooper Union to celebrate the class of 2020's 70th reunion, you will look back upon your time at Cooper Union with the same pride and joy that he does. Congratulations, class of 2020.
Good morning. I'm Anne Griffin, Acting Dean of the Faculty of Humanities and Social Sciences. Each year, the faculty and deans recognize some of the extraordinary achievements of our graduates in each of the three professional schools with awards made possible by generous alumni and friends. On behalf of my colleagues, It is my pleasure to thank these benefactors for recognizing the tremendous potential of our students by creating the student prizes and awards. Graduation represents the achievement of one immense personal journey and the beginning of another one. I hope that you will carry with you all that you have learned in our courses and that it will deepen your understanding of whatever you do in the next phase or phases of your life. I can promise you this. You will discover that learning is a lifelong experience. Knowing how to learn will serve you well. Since coming to Cooper Union in 1978, I've learned a good deal more from you. So I would like to share with you some of the lessons I've learned with thanks. Be bold. Trust yourself. Listen to your intuition. Know the difference between what is possible for others and what is possible for you. Take risks. Take risks in your thinking and in your actions. Dare to imagine. Embrace serendipity. Treasure the unexpected. Trust your imagination to use it well. Be humble. Be open. No matter how far you go, no matter whom you meet, recognize your parallel journeys and your common humanity. You have everything to gain and everything to learn. Congratulations to the class of 2020.
Hi everyone, I'm Stephen Hillier, director of the Irwin S. Chanin School of Architecture Archive and a 1990 graduate of the school. I've been a member of the Cooper community for 30 years. While I can't say that I know all of the graduates today, I would say to those in art and engineering that I'm sure we've passed each other in the hallways of the Foundation Building in 41 Cooper Square numerous times. So today I'm going to speak to the 2020 graduates in architecture. I've had the really good fortune of collaborating with you over the years and presenting your work and working with a smaller number of you down in the archive on our special projects. And I want you all to know that I am ever inspired by the thoughtful approach you bring to every single thing you do. It is just truly amazing. And you and your peers are really the heartbeat of the third floor. As you know, I, in my role at Cooper Union, observe, document, and disseminate the work of the school. But that also means that I get to track the development of your creative growth over the time that you're Cooper Union students. And it's a really formative time, as you know, and I encourage you to always look back on these moments because they will continue to inform your trajectory as you move forward. I don't think anybody could have imagined that we would be ending the semester remotely, and I'm sure you never thought you would be presenting your final projects over Zoom. But I want you to know this, the strength of the work and the intellectuality that you brought to the projects was simply phenomenal. You have flown in the face of this pandemic. So now, as you're prepared to face the challenges ahead, please don't forget that you have ingenuity and you have a sense of responsibility that you've honed here that is going to serve you well moving into the future. I'm sure you've heard of the effort to fabricate PPP by harnessing the ACE lab in the Foundation Building, and it was a great cause that connected the disciplines of art, architecture, and engineering with the support of facilities and administration. And I'm happy to have had the opportunity to play a small role in that. And what that really reminded me is that the concept of giving back is really embedded within the foundations of this institution, the ethos of this institution, and the education that we were all given as a gift by Peter Cooper. And I know that everybody can do things in their own way, and I know you will do your part. And I want you also to know that all of us in the School of Architecture are here to support you in any way we can. Please don't forget that. So I know that this is a bittersweet moment. It's meant to be a celebration, but I'm going to tell you this. I feel very much like I can look forward to the day where we are all back on campus in the Great Hall, and we're cheering you on as you cross the stage. So until then, I look forward to your leadership as a group of emerging young architects who are fortified with a knowledge and a sense of responsibility that we all need right now. So thank you, I celebrate you, and I can't wait to see you again.
Hi everybody, Brad Samuels, Cooper, class of 2005, architecture, and partner at C2. I've been asked to reflect a little bit about my education at Cooper and what about it prepared me well for this moment in time. Obviously, it's a moment of great adversity, a lot of uncertainty, a lot of suffering. And it's really for these reasons that I feel particularly grateful to have such a strong foundation. My time at Cooper was what allowed me to figure out my values, what was important to me to really form opinions about architecture's relationship to society at large. And it's serving me well at this moment in time. And so I think everyone that's graduating should feel a tremendous sense of pride and solace in the fact that you're moving into the world with this incredible education. So congratulations.
To my fellow classmates, graduates of the class of 2020, may the last 5 years of constant transition, uncertainty, and change be of some solace to you on this great occasion of your commencement. Yes, this is a new beginning, and with it will come new thresholds for which there's just no script nor curriculum. We've lived through some challenging times together. First, in seeing through a transition after a turmoil we both missed. Then, with the arrival of new leadership, repositioning the mission of full scholarships at the Cooper Union. Subsequently, working diligently to craft a curriculum that might maintain its open and exploratory potentials while prompting emerging modes of representation, analysis, and communication. All this allowing new voices to emerge while respecting the wisdom of those that have set the tone we have inherited. Of those voices, we've also endured loss and mourned together. With some of you, I've had the pleasure of travel, of breaking bread, and of sharing time outside the academic context. I came to the Cooper Union to become a student again, and you gave me the pleasure of a cohort with whom to associate. And for that, I thank you immensely. As we imagined your final year here, we projected many scenarios, but alas, the current one was not part of our imagination. The studio that is the core of our pedagogical ethos was taken away from us, and in a matter of days, you had to recreate a new space, virtual and intellectual as it may be, within which the community you've come to take as natural could gain equal vitality. Indeed, nothing is perfect about the spaces we've discovered in the last few months, but you've also demonstrated the need for creating dangerously under circumstances of urgency. I borrow these words of Albert Camus in his eponymous essay of 1957, where he speaks to the power and responsibility of the artist. Risk and freedom loom large in his equation. Free artists are those who, with great difficulty, create order themselves. The more chaos they must bring order to, the stricter their rules will be, and the more they will have affirmed their freedom. The risk and danger to which he speaks may be different than that which we face today in our current world of isolated bodies. And yet it is precisely this isolation that has forced you to reckon with the disciplines you have so mastered in order to gain your voice. You have written eloquently. You have computed drawings of 9H precision. You've animated worlds otherwise stagnant, and you've brought to life impossible worlds through your imagination. You did all this using the very same picture plane through which I speak to you today, and somehow our absent bodies made the urgencies of the modes of representation gain the role of invention they both need and deserve. So as you step out, beyond the walls of Cooper Union, may you extend the discipline of risk and engage the world. Don't stop now. Continue to create dangerously.
Hi, Cooper class of 2020. Emily Oberman here, class of 85. First of all, congratulations on graduating. It's a terrific achievement. You should be proud of yourselves. I'm sure this isn't exactly what you pictured when you first started, but eventually there'll be a celebration. In the meantime, the good news is that Cooper has already prepared you for what to do next. And right at this moment in time, what to do next could be to use your voice and your talent to do something to help the world. It's a strange moment, and having the skills, the brains, the talent to put voice to a thought is a wonderful thing to be able to do. I was recently asked, along with a group of other artists, designers, illustrators, to create a series of posters that would be up around the city on the streets and in Times Square that would thank people for doing what they can to be a voice of positivity in this dark moment. It felt good to be part of that, and I know that Cooper Union really helped prepare me for thinking that way, for being able to voice a thought. So, with that, I say to you, go out there, do something, say something, help, and enjoy your life. Thanks. Bye.
Hi, my name is Lena Imamura.
I'm Yuri Mazdy, and we're graduates of the School of Art.
And we wanted to say congratulations on completing your training and welcome to the extended family.
Your Cooper family, our family, is a group of obsessed, passionate, driven, and strange people. And that's the unspoken connection between all of us. Only Cooper grads will truly understand you.
And we wanted to share with you what we thought the most important thing that you learned at Cooper was, which is the ability to realize and see your ideas all the way through.
As you go out into the world, you'll experience that there are a lot of people out there with ideas. There are fewer people with good ideas, and even fewer people who can bring interesting ideas into the world and see them all the way through.
And at Cooper, you learn to articulate your ideas, give shape to them, refine them, explore them, find tools and resources to build them, and really share them out into the world.
And what got you into the school in the first place was your divergent thinking. But here, you learn the practice of resourcefulness, discipline, and heart.
And it's this practice that really binds us together across generations, decades, disciplines, and even industries as Cooper grads.
So we'd like to wish the class of 2020 congratulations on graduating and the best of luck out there.
Bye.
Bye.
Congratulations to the class of 2020. You probably all know how much Cooper Union means to me, and I wish I could be taking photos with you and that strange Peter Cooper statue we bring out at graduation. If any of you would like to join me on Zoom for a celebratory screenshot, you know where to find me, and I promise to wear a weird t-shirt featuring a fellow Cooper grad. I know these 4 years have been challenging for all of you, and especially difficult now. Walk your way back to the divisive election of 2016 as the first moment in your journey, and then walk forward to this moment now. A pandemic that has upended anyone's expectations of what life would look like in 2020. A lot has happened, and a lot has happened to you personally. Most of you arrived here fresh from high school. You are now artists. We've seen you and your work grow from your thoughtful assignments in foundation year to developing incredible personal practices in art and design. You've learned critical thinking and explored the depths of critical theory. You've engaged in social practice. You led efforts to decolonize our humanities curriculum. You have made us better mentors, teachers, listeners, and community members. Your class possesses a unique gift to think broadly and fluently across paradigms. How you solve problems in the future will impact us all in many positive ways. And this work all started in art school, but not just any art school. I like to think this only happens at Cooper Union. I'm proud of all of you, and I'm proud to be your dean. To the School of Art seniors, thank you for your patience and your perseverance. We are committed to inviting you back to make work and have shows, and we look forward to working with you if you choose to return. I applaud each and every one of you for showing us how committed you are to your work and our community. We will be here if you need us as you head out and start your practice. Cooper's roots run deep, and you'll see this more and more the further out from school you get. My professors were there for me when I graduated back in 96, and you can trust we will do the same for you. I love you all and wish you the best. Stay safe, stay connected. And again, for me, Adriana, and everyone in the School of Art, congratulations and good luck.
Hi, I'm Shannon, proud Cooper grad, civil engineering, 1996. I know you guys are super bummed this year because it didn't end the way you wanted. There was no senior project presentations, no senior art shows, no procession, no graduation in the Great Hall. But I want to welcome you to join the over 160 years of Cooper alums. And we need you now more than ever. We need your brains, your tenacity, and your creativity to help us solve the world's problems. During this crazy COVID time, I use my Cooper education here at this wastewater treatment plant to protect the environment and public health. I am incredibly proud to be a Cooper grad, and we are proud of you. Welcome, class of 2020.
Hi, everyone. My name is Shekhar Krishnan, and I first want to congratulate the entire Cooper class of 2020. This is no ordinary time to be graduating college. I'm myself an alum of Cooper, the class of 2006. I'm now a lawyer for low-income tenants in our city, fighting to defend them from eviction and harassment by their landlords. I'm also a community activist in Jackson Heights, Queens, where for the last couple months, I've been working to secure PPE, much needed PPE, for Elmhurst Hospital. We are a community of immigrants and frontline workers. And one of the things that stands out to me from this crisis is that the world that we enter after this pandemic, the world that you all enter after graduation, it has now been laid bare, the deep-seated systemic inequities and injustices in our city, in our society, and how the most vulnerable are our communities of color, our immigrant communities. So I would urge all of you, with the privilege and power of our Cooper education, not just an academic education, but a humanitarian education about our city, about structural inequalities, I would urge all of you to use the privilege of our education to fight for the world that we believe in, for the values that we believe in. Because as we can see, government will not, cannot do it. We all have to do so together as a movement. And I hope you'll use your education to stand with all of us in solidarity in doing so. Congratulations to all of you. An amazing job on a year that's been incredibly difficult. I hope to see you all on the road ahead.
Graduates of the School of Engineering, class of 2020, you've made it. On behalf of the entire faculty and staff of the Albert Nurkin School of Engineering, I want to convey our most sincere congratulations. We are all very proud of you and your achievements and your accomplishments. We're here today to celebrate you, the members of the class of 2020, who spent so much time with us over the past 4 years. While no doubt all have struggled at one point or another along this journey, you all join us here today as graduates of the Cooper Union. Your original decision to come to one of the most prestigious and selective engineering schools in the nation, with a rich heritage and legacy for producing exceptionally talented engineers with a sense of social justice, who apply their expertise and leadership for the benefit of society and humanity, sets you apart from other engineering graduates. In the words of Robert Frost, you took the road less traveled. Let me just take a minute to reflect on your journey. During your time here, you have really become part of us, part of the Cooper Engineering family. In our classes and labs, we taught you the foundational concepts of our disciplines, the blocking and tackling of civil, chemical, electrical, mechanical, and general engineering. Through this journey, which I'm sure sometimes seemed like an odyssey, you have struggled with and mastered difficult concepts, and even foreign languages like Python, C, and vector calculus. Through it all, you not only persevered, but you excelled. Class of 2020, we, your faculty, have had a unique vantage point from which to watch you grow and mature in your discipline. You have done some amazing things while you were with us. Members traveled to foreign countries like Israel, Iceland, Spain, and Germany to gain insights and perspectives on different cultures. You participated in a wide variety of internships that took you across the country and the globe to work with the likes of Google, Facebook, ExxonMobil, Con Edison, and many, many others. You traveled to conferences and published the results of your projects and research at some of the premier undergraduate conferences in the nation. You honed your engineering and organizational skills in extracurricular team competitions that brought home numerous awards and prizes. The number of entrepreneurial projects that have led to startup funding and won innovation awards were truly amazing. And the numerous initiatives focused on sustainability, resiliency, and social good demonstrate your commitment to improving our world. You should be proud of what you have accomplished while you were here. We certainly are. We're sorry to see the class of 2020 leave, but we are truly excited with anticipation to see what you will do out in the world. Let me leave you with a quote by T.S. Eliot. Only those who will risk going too far can possibly find out how far one can go. Go out there and do great things.
It's a million miles away and I'm still thinking about my baby. Hey, misbehaving, no, you don't need to worry. I'm having a good time. And I've had one too many, but you're the only one on my mind.
I am misbehaving towards you. I am misbehaving.
my mind.